Hi, this is Brian from Denmark, your tech friend, always at your international service. I was thinking about always at your funeral service, but then I let it go, perhaps for a good reason. Today I'm going to speak to you about my favorite phone, the phone I'm using right now the most. And of course, as a phone reviewer and tester, I get a lot of phones through my house. And as you can probably tell from the thumbnail, I have a lot of phones lying around. Just to debunk a notion you may have just right off the bat, I am not a healthy person, I'm not a rich man. I'm a student I'm studying innovation and entrepreneurship here in Denmark, Copenhagen. And I've been actually believing on what you would consider like the poor, just in the limit of being called poor by Danish standards here in Denmark. So I'm not a rich guy, I'm really believing on the limits, so I feel at least. But then finally, this spring came a little revelation. I got a student job, and that makes me like $400 to $500 a month. And that just makes me able to work this market of the used phones market primarily. I also occasionally buy a new phone. But that really opened up a space for me to buy all these phones that you see in the thumbnail. And I will now go through talking to you about narrowing down to my favorite phone and most used phone right now. Okay, first off, we're gonna talk about this guy, the phone I'm recording this session with, and that's the one on the outer left of the picture of the thumbnail. That's the Zenfone 6. It is my go-to camera. It's the ideal vlogger phone because I can view myself, how I stand, my stance. I can easily monitor everything before I make the shot. So let alone because of that reason, I may be calling that my favorite phone for the time being. But it is not because I don't like using it as a phone. It's very, very heavy. It's very bulky. And you're always concerned about that flip camera. The reason I'm concerned about it the most is because if I were to drop it, and it's even now it's a relatively high priced secondhand device, it's around $300 here in Denmark if you should buy it secondhand. That's some kind of money to have like destroyed for just using it as an ordinary phone. So because it has such a good camera and good audio quality, as you can tell, and the monitoring ability, I am not using that phone for my primary phone or my favorite phone at this moment. And then let's take a look at the next one. Okay, so that was where the Asus Zenfone 6 lie on the picture. Then the next one, we've got the Motorola One Zoom. And that's actually, of course, of the exact same reason I'm not using this right now. Actually, not having even taken it to use right now, but that's because I just bought it secondhand. But that is exactly the same reason as for the Asus. It's too big, it's too wide. I just know this, it's too wide that it's gonna be a phone that I will actually be using in daily life. So the Motorola One Zoom, I will be testing it as my primary phone, but it will never become like a device I will use for an extended period of time because it's just too wide. And that's a tip I just want to give you. Always trust your own feelings when you buy a device. Don't listen to like Mr. Who's the Boss and MKGSB or what they call all the big the tech expert and all the big guys, the tech chap. Don't listen to them. Go down in the store and feel the phone in your hand for yourself because the phone's got to match you as a personality and you as your physique. And that's really, really important when you buy a phone. As you can see, by the way, I've of course lined them up. Aligned them in like size, and that of course reveals a lot about my preferences also, because if the Zoom was too big, then most likely the Sony XZ2 will also be too big, and it is. And I've also not used this as my primary phone yet because I just know it's going to be too big. I'm going to do a Vlogger's Delight test on this phone, and that's pretty much going to be it for this, I think. I don't know. If you want to know anything about it, please let me know. Then there is another phone that goes under the same category. It's just too wide. This, I don't like using wide phones in normal everyday use. This is the Samsung A10, and there's coming a review up. I'm doing a comparison with the Huawei Y5 actually, and that will come very soon, within weeks. Also, this phone is just too slow at multitasking, but watch out for that review, and bye bye to the Samsung A10. Then we have, from the low end, you can see here's an iPhone 6, a bit roughed up. That's because I also just bought it to make the camera test if it stood, but actually this one also had a mic test, so I couldn't even do it, the Vlogger's Delight version of this phone. But what I really, really like about the iPhone 6 design, and this of course its size, just compare it to like the Motorola One Zoom. Just take a look at the difference on these two guys. That is just a matter of preference. How much thinner is it? How narrow is it? Yeah, that's almost like a centimeter less wide it is. And I really, really like the form factor of the iPhone 6. Actually, and I'm gonna reveal to you already now, please subscribe to this channel if you wanna follow me into that journey. I owned the iPhone 6 for about like 6 years ago. That was the big version actually. 5 years ago, sir. And I've never been accustomed to the iPhone iOS ecosystem yet. And I can't, until now, I haven't had an iPhone for more than 14 days. That's what I'm trying to say. But I have told myself, now I gotta try it again. So when the iOS 14 comes out, and if I could get a hand of like an iPhone 11 Pro, that's actually my preference phone. I would prefer size-wise to try a, or perhaps it would just be an iPhone 7 or 8 or something. And then I will test the iOS 14 with this small form factor phone, and I'll see if that would be to my liking, finally. We'll see about that. But of course, as right now, the iPhone is going out the window, it's too cracked. And then, of course, the next smallest one I've got in my collection right now is the Samsung S6. I actually owned the Samsung S4, and I really, really liked it. I love that phone, besides the physical button. That was another thing I was gonna say about the iPhone. I don't like a physical button. You can see this has been taking quite a beating. It's actually, it's pretty funny. You can see it's actually been bended. If I remove my face, you can actually see the bend of the phone. So the guy I bought it from, he's been sat down on this phone in his pocket. Anyhow, I really, really like the sturdy build of this Samsung S6. And it is actually a great phone. So if it could be updated to like Android 10, then I would actually consider this phone, had it not been for the physical button, and of course in this case a cracked screen too. But bye bye to the Sammy. Then we are moving a bit up size, we are going up size again. And this is the Huawei P10. This actually has a very nice form factor. Yeah, I like most of it. And by the way, I really, really, really like the Emotion UI. That's Huawei's overlay to on the Android system. I really, really like it. So the Huawei P10, that actually could be a contender for a phone I would use right now. But I'm not, because this one in particular has a very poor battery. Plus, it has like a subpar camera performance on the selfie cameras. Don't really like that, because I'm vlogging. Vlogging for fun, you know, and that's what I like to do. And then there is this dude that's actually now survived as my primary device for like almost going on 2 weeks now, actually. I was just meant to do a test on it. It's the Huawei Y5. And this phone also coming up in the comparison with the Samsung A10. I can't recommend this by any measuring points, what you're gonna call it. So please go ahead and look up that review when it comes up here. At some point, it's a horrible phone. Okay. And then we are down to our final two candidates for my favorite phone and the phone I'm using right now. This is the Motorola One Action. And I've been using that for, it's out of juice. I've been using that for quite some time. I've been using that for 2 months. And you know what happened? It performed so strong out of the box. I thought, okay, this is my dream phone. It fulfills my needs to like just the acceptable level. But then all of a sudden, it didn't. Sometimes we didn't want to do payments when I was at the the checking out at stores, and then even worse, it stopped. It didn't want to call anybody unless I reboot or restart the phone. And who wants a phone that needs to restart to make a phone call? Okay, of course, this may be a fault with this particular Motorola One Action, and I will be trying to hand it in and get a new one, not a Motorola Action, but a new phone, or perhaps just a refund or anything, I don't know. We'll see about that, but of course, that makes this phone say bye-bye, and that leaves only now the Sony Xperia 10 Mark 1. Not the recent one, there's just been one released here in 2020. This is the Mark 1, and I bought this also secondhand for testing purposes. But the fun thing about it is I've been using it as my secondary device, and it's just, it has this. And then we go back to the thing I talked about in the start. Try and listen. It has this kind of nice tactile feel to the back. It's been a bit roughed up a bit. It was a border for work, but still, I feel it's, and it has this rounded edges. It is so nice to just have in your hand and hold. And I don't think you need a cover for this phone because it's just nice to hold right out of the box. I just forgot to say that the form factor, both of these phones are relatively slim. That's why I actually like them, even though they're pretty high. So this is my favorite device and the device I'm using the most right at this moment. I don't have to do a test on this Huawei Y5 or NPS. Anyhow, I will be testing the Motorola soon. Pretty soon. Tell me if there's anything you want to know about these phones, in particular the phones I haven't tested yet, and just write them in the comments if there's anything you want to know about these phones. I'm in position right now, and of course I will be selling some of them on to get some of my hard-earned stupid money back. But right now we have a winner, and it's the Sony Xperia 10.